So the next classification is based on the number of axes. The axis in a CNC represents the directions in which there can be a relative motion between the tool and the workpiece. So if you say a CNC machine is a two-axis system, then there can be motions along two axes. So if we take the example of a lathe, there are only two axes along which the relative motion can be there. The first one is the z-axis, that is the along the length of the workpiece. The spindle is rotating about the z-axis here. Then the x-axis, the tool will move along the x-axis, the tool can move along the z-axis. So along these two axes there are going to be the movement. The spindle rotation is usually not considered as an additional axis, because without the spindle rotation in case of the lathe, or the drill bit rotation in case of the drilling machine, or the tool rotation in case of the CNC milling machine, basically no material removal takes place. So if you are removing that particular motion, then if you are seeing this, then the tool motion along z-axis and tool motion along x-axis, these two represents the two axes that are available in the CNC lathe system. So it is basically a two-axis system. Next one is a three-axis system, where you can have the movement along x-axis, you can have movement along y-axis, and the vertical movement of the spindle, that will be the z-axis. The spindle will be having its own rotation, so we will not be considering that as an axis of motion. It is by default. There will be three additional movements along x-axis positive and negative, y-axis positive and negative, and z-axis positive and negative. So the example will be it can be a drilling machine, or it can be a CNC milling machine. So both are possible. A four-axis system, again, it can be an extension of the milling machine, where the table workpiece which is mounted, it can be given an additional rotation. So that you are having the tool which is mounted in the spindle, it will be having the up and down movement. The table can move in x direction and it can move in y direction. Apart from that, you are having a special motor available here, which will ensure that the workpiece mounted can be rotated about this particular axis, giving the motion along the fourth axis. So it is possible to drill holes at an angle to the surface, which is not possible in case of a three-axis machine without using specialized fixtures. So next is the five-axis system, where apart from the x, y and z motions of the tool, we will be having additional movements to the workpiece to get more complicated profiles. So the video will show you are having a rotation about the conical axis of the workpiece, and also the entire table is being tilted to get the required complicated profile of the impeller over here. So it is rotating about this axis, and the entire table, that is also rotating, apart from x, y and z movements given to this particular spindle, that is three axis, the rotation about this axis is the fourth one, the entire table is tilting, giving it the five axis. So the more number of axes, the controller also becomes much more complicated because of the synchronous movement required between the various axes. And the cost of the system also increases with higher number of axes available in the system. Next classification of the CNC machines is based on the drive mechanism. We can have electrical drives, hydraulic drives and pneumatic drives. More commonly used ones are electric and hydraulic drives for driving the spindle and the axis movements. Pneumatic drives are not usually used for movement of the tool or for the workpiece movements because of its low accuracy. But pneumatic drives are used for very fast movement, that may be for changing of the tools, clamping of the workpieces. Pneumatic drives can be used. For getting the accurate positioning, usually electric drives or hydraulic drives are used. Hydraulic drives, again, they can give linear motion as well as rotary motion. Electrical drives can give more of a rotary motion. If you want linear motion, again you have to use some kind of converter, maybe a lead screw. A conventional lead screw is not used because of higher friction. A recirculating ball screw is used, which is having less amount of friction and improves the efficiency. So you can have AC motors, you can have DC motors. So hydraulic drives, you should have the entire power pack, hydraulic power pack mounted in the system. Hydraulic fluid will be supplied through the pump into the various drives. You will be having different types of control valves to control and regulate the motion of the various axes. So electric drives and hydraulic drives both will provide good accuracy and also good rigidity. Hydraulic drives are more rigid as compared to the electrical drives. Hydraulic drives are having higher power capacities and also good accuracy. Electric drives are much more easier to control. Usually for spindle drives, electrical motors are used. Pneumatic drives are more commonly used for clamping and unclamping of the workpieces and for changeover of the tools.